Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, and today we are going to learn how to create a lambda function using CloudFormation. So basically there are two different ways with the help of which we can create a lambda function. The first way is by including the function within the CloudFormation template, that is inline function, and the second way is by storing the function zip file in S3 bucket and then referencing it into our CloudFormation template. So we'll be performing both of these one by one. So let's get started. So first I'll be opening my browser and searching for AWS Lambda CloudFormation. So now you can see that AWS Lambda function resource creates a Lambda function. Right, so this is basically the type of our resource when we want to create a Lambda function. Then to create a Lambda function, we require a deployment package as well as an execution rule. Okay, since we are mentioning the function within our CloudFormation template itself, we don't require any deployment package as such. So we'll be working only with role in the first approach. Okay, so now I'll go and search AWS IAM CloudFormation. Okay, within this I'll directly go to the examples and grab few things from this particular template. Okay, so I'll just take what's necessary for me to create the Lambda function and open the editor. Now in this you can see that I have already created a YAML file, okay, which is empty of course. Now I'll be adding the first resource, that is my Lambda role. Okay, so now you can see that they have mentioned AWS template format version right here. Then for the resources, we'll be first mentioning the logical ID of that particular role. So I'll change this to my Lambda role. Okay, the type will remain as it is. So most of the things I won't be changing them as of now. So the rest of the things, that is version, then statement, and within that we have got effect, that is allow. But the service that we are working with is Lambda, so I need to replace this EC2 with Lambda. Okay, and for the action I'll be keeping it as it is. Then also for the path, it's the default thing. Then within the policies, the policy name is root, I'll keep it as it is. And within the policy document, we have mentioned the version followed by the statement, and within the statement for the action I'll be just adding S3 right here, since I want my Lambda to work with S3 in future also. Like for both the approaches will require a role, right? So for considering both the things in mind, I have just added the action as S3 right here, and resource I'll be keeping it as it is. So now we are done with the creation of our role. Now we want to create a Lambda function. Okay, so we'll go to this particular section and we can see that this is the YAML template and we have so many properties right here. Okay, but we won't be using all of them, we'll be using few which are necessary. The only one that is required and should be present within your Lambda function is role, because of which we created this particular role first, and then we'll be adding the reference of that in our Lambda function. Okay, so now let's go to my editor. Now I'll be adding the name of my resource, or we can say the logical ID, my Lambda function. Okay, and now I'll be mentioning the type, and the type is of course AWS lambda function, which we already had seen in the documentation, and properties. Okay, within the properties we have got the foremost and important thing, that is role, which is required. Okay, I'll be referencing it with the help of get at, and the name of my function is my lambda role. Sorry, my lambda role, and I'll be referencing the ARN over here. Okay, and now after this, I have got one more property, that is runtime, which is also required while mentioning. And in here, you can go and search this stuff right here. Okay, so within the runtime, you can see that we have got so many values right here. You can use any of them, whichever you require, according to the type of function that you are going to use. So I'll be making use of this particular value for my runtime. Okay, now after this, I'll be mentioning the handler. Now, since I am using the inline function, I will be making use of index. Okay, and within that, I'll be mentioning the name of the function that I am going to define in my code. Okay, so this is the name of the function that I'm gonna use. Then after this, we have got code property, wherein within the zip file, I'll be mentioning the function name as lambda handler, right? And of course, these are the parameters. Sorry, this here we have got context. Okay, and within this, I'll be returning hello world. Okay, so that's it for this. We can also add tags over here. Okay, so within the tag, I have got key, that is name, and within the value, I'll be adding the name as my lambda function. So now I'm done creating a role as well as a lambda function, and now we are ready to go. Okay, so now we'll go to our CloudFormation stack, and within this, I'll be creating the stack. Since my template is ready, I'll be uploading a template file. Okay, so I'll be entering the stack name is my stack for lambda function. Okay, I'll be moving to the next, and rest of the things will be as it is. And since we are working with IAM role, it is asking me to acknowledge that AWS CloudFormation might create IAM resources. So I'll acknowledge it and submit. Now we can see that all the resources got created. Now we'll go to our lambda function. Now you can see that this is the name of my stack, and this is the name with which I have created my logical ID, right? So now you can see that my function is over here, and now I can test this. Okay, so I'll just go and name it as my event and save. Now I'll be testing it. Now you can see the status has succeeded, so this got successfully created. Okay, so in this way we can create a lambda function with the inline function. Now the next step or the next approach that we can deal with is by creating a function and then converting it into a zip file, and after creating it, converting it into zip file, we'll then push it or upload it on our S3 bucket, okay, from which we'll be referencing it. Okay, so the rest of the things I'll be keeping it as it is. So the thing that I'll be adding right here in the same file is I'll be removing this. But before removing this, I would like to create one more file right here named as lambda.py. Okay, so now what I'll do is I'll take this code, okay, go to this particular file, paste it. Okay, this is what I'll be doing. I'll be removing this zip file. Okay, now for the code we have got different options right here, so I'll go to the documentation first, and within the code we'll be seeing that we have got these many options right here, wherein we can mention the S3 bucket also, as well as S3 key as well. So these two things we can mention there. Okay, so first we'll have to create an S3 bucket. Okay, so I'll go to my this particular stuff, I'll go to S3. You can create this S3 via your CloudFormation also, no problem with that as well, but I'll be creating it manually. Okay, so I'll go and create a bucket, and the name of the bucket is my bucket for lambda. Okay, I'll be mentioning it right that way. I will be enabling the bucket versioning and rest of the things as it is and create bucket. Okay, there's no uppercase required. Okay, or we can just add a lambda function. Okay, so now I'll go and create bucket. Now we can see that this bucket got created, right? Now what I'll do is I'll go to my this particular lambda file. Okay, this is my .py file, right? Now I will be sending it to compressed zipped folder with the name. Yeah, I'll keep it lambda only. Okay, so I'll be uploading this particular lambda over here. So upload, and within the upload I will be dragging add files. We'll be adding this particular file that is lambda.zip and upload. Now this file got successfully uploaded to my this particular S3 bucket. Okay, so what I'll do over here, now we are done with the other part. Now we'll go to our YAML file and we'll be mentioning these two values over here inside the code. Okay, so for the S3 bucket I have given the name as my bucket for lambda function. Okay, and For the S3 key, I will be mentioning the name of my lambda.zip. Okay, so this is the name of my zip folder. Okay, so, and one more thing, with for the handler, I won't be making use of index. Now I will be making use of lambda, since this is the name of my file, right? That is zip file. Okay, so I'll be saving now, and now I'll go to CloudFormation steps. I will try to delete the previous one. Yeah, so I'll wait for it to delete. Now I'll go and create this. Okay, I will be uploading a template file. This is my template. Here we go. And next, stack name is my stack for lambda. Okay, next, the rest of the things as it is, next. And I acknowledge, submit. Now we can see that the creation is completed. We'll now go to the resources, and within the resources for the lambda function specifically, now you can see that this is the file with which we are working, right? And now we'll try to test it. So my event, save. Now we'll be testing it. It is working successfully, right? So in this way, you can create lambda function using CloudFormation, and there are two different approaches that you can follow while creating it. Hope you found the video helpful. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel if you found the video is helpful. Also, don't forget to press that bell icon for the latest updates. And if you have got any doubt in any of the things that I have done right here, then you can mention them in the comment section. So, thank you so much and have a nice day.